Hey guys, Javen here, and welcome back to part two of my OFDM basic series. In this video, I'll be covering how to generate and analyze DFT spread OFDM waveforms on the Rodenschwartz SMW200A vector signal generator and FSW spectrum and signal analyzer. In this video, I'm going to start with the CP-OFDM signal, and we'll then enable transform precoding for the data allocation. And that'll give us a DFT spread OFDM signal. So let's dive in. We'll go to baseband, OFDM signal generation, set the export path, use shares FSW that we created in a previous video. On general settings, we'll set this to 10 symbols, same that we had previously. We'll leave the DFT-s disabled for now, and we'll leave the allocation at default. We'll enable this, increase power level to negative 10 dBm, and enable RF. Now we've got an identical setup to what we had before. On the spectrum analyzer, we'll go to 1 GHz. A 40 meg span. And I'll change the trace detector type here to RMS so we can see the shape of the waveform a little bit better. And to smooth out this trace, I could either add trace averaging or I could just increase the measurement time. All right, so let's take that trace and copy it to memory. I'm going to add some trace labels here. So the first one is going to be our DFT-s OFDM trace, and the second one that we just copied is our CP. OFDM. I'm going to drag those trace labels down here. And let's demodulate the cyclic prefix OFDM waveform. This is the identical setup from before. We'll note that the constellation here, so long as the settings for the sample rate, center frequency, FFT size, the cyclic prefix length are all correct, we'll see that 64 QAM data allocation shown in here. So that's kind of convenient. You get immediate reassurance without even having to load your config XML file. Let's go ahead and load that file, go to our shared directory here. There we go, we're demodulating that signal. We're at negative 51 dB EVM and a 10.7 dB crest factor. Go ahead and rename this here so we don't get it confused in the next step. And jump back to the spectrum view. All right, let's go ahead and enable the DFT precoding. So this is the only additional step that we have to add. DFTS, we'll check that. And see the shape of the waveform here is extremely similar. In fact, you probably wouldn't even be able to tell whether the signal is DFT spread or not just by looking at the frequency domain information. You'd actually have to demodulate it. Let's go ahead and jump in the demodulation here. Change the window title. This is our DFT-s-OFDM demod. And first thing off the bat, without having the config XML file loaded, is the constellation looks like it's completely scrambled. I can't really see that 64 QAM data structure that we had before, because that's effectively what the DFT spreading is doing, is it's scrambling the data across all the subcarriers. So let's go ahead and load the config file, enable transform precoding, and this basically undoes the process that the DFT-s did over on the signal generator. And we've got a very similar EVM here, likewise for the crest factor. There's our first look into analyzing and generating a DFT spread OFDM waveform on the SMW200A and FSW. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.